93.8 FM, online at cna.asia, and from January, streaming on Me Listen.
This is CNA 938. Understand Asia.
Now, Asia First, live from Hong Kong with Yasmin Yonkers and Adam Bucktail.
Good morning. You're watching Asia First on this Thursday. I'm Adam Bakhtia together with Yasmin Yonkers. We're here in Hong Kong with a special simulcast on CNA TV and CNA 938 Radio. And we're looking at the impact of nearly 6 months of anti-government protests.
Well, the breaking news this morning, and you did this for everybody, President Donald Trump signing the Hong Kong Human Rights and Democracy Bill about an hour ago. It's a move supporting protesters and one that will anger Chinese leaders. And we're here in Hong Kong today to talk about what's ahead for this city's economy that's now enduring its first recession in a decade.
And we've got so much more ahead, but first, let's send it back to our Singapore TV and radio studios for the day's top stories.
Thank you very much, Asia First Hong Kong. Good morning from Arnold Gay and Susan Ng here in Singapore. Also coming up this hour, public agencies here will only be able to collect and keep your data when it's strictly necessary.
And moving on to some food and vegetables in Singapore, we hear that some hotels here are growing their own vegetables and rearing their own fish to give guests a farm-to-fork experience. All that coming up after the news.
U.S. President Donald Trump has signed into law congressional legislation backing the protesters in Hong Kong. This is in spite of Beijing's objections. Our correspondent in Washington, D.C., Harry Horton, has more.
President Trump has noted in a statement in signing this bill, he says certain provisions of the act would interfere with the exercise of the president's constitutional authority to state the foreign policy of the United States. So making pretty clear in that statement that he's not very happy about the fact that he's had to sign this bill into law. Simultaneously, he's also signed another bill into law, a small bill. This bill prohibits U.S. exports of specified police equipment to Hong Kong. In addition to signing these two bills, President Trump has put out a statement in which he says, I signed these bills out of respect for President Xi, China, and the people of Hong Kong. They are being enacted in the hope that leaders and representatives of China and Hong Kong will be able to amicably settle their differences, leading to long-term peace and prosperity for all. I think there is some concern that this will do some damage to the relationship with China. But I think President Trump, in these statements that he's issued alongside the signing of these bills, I think his message is to President Xi in Beijing is, look, my hands were tied here. I had little choice but to sign these bills into law. And, in expressing my disapproval of these bills, I hope it won't do too much damage to that U.S.-China relationship.
Our correspondent in Washington, Harry Horton. CNA earlier spoke with Edward Yao, Hong Kong's Commerce and Economic Development Secretary, and he says the U.S. legislation is both unwarranted and unnecessary.
It unnecessarily harms the mutual and common interest between Hong Kong and U.S. And I think Hong Kong affairs need to be tackled by Hong Kong instead of somebody else, right? And another worry is, in fact, the wrong signal that such a bill was sent to Hong Kong people. Because, well, if you continue to watch sort of TV coverage on Hong Kong, there are certainly things that go beyond the so-called red line, the kind of violence being deployed on the street, the attack on premises and some people. Well, certainly, I think every society would need to maintain that very important line.
That's Hong Kong Commerce and Economic Development Secretary Edward Yao. Now, all this comes as the standoff at Hong Kong's Polytechnic University could be at an end. It's been ongoing for 11 long days. Police forces have had the campus surrounded 24/7. But now they plan to go in to remove any remaining anti-government protesters. Authorities say that safety teams made up of explosive disposal personnel and other experts will enter campus grounds to gather evidence. They will also remove hazardous materials such as corrosive liquid and petrol bombs. And they will advise protesters still on site to seek medical attention before taking down their details. Here's Ho Yun-sing, Chief Superintendent of Yao Chim District.